Okay, it's 26 people up in here, I guess. Can everybody hear me? Can everybody hear? Can everybody hear me and hear me good? Sean, I don't know what YouTube got going on with this chat and why it's so cray cray. But I don't like it. Because they have it like shorter or something. I don't know. I don't really fool with it. But whatever. I don't care. What's good, y'all? Shout out to the folks that is here. Y'all make sure to hit that like button as y'all enter. It's gonna help me get pushed through the algorithm or whatever, because y'all know YouTube is playing with the content creators again. I really only feel like it's just the grams. But So, please make sure to like up if y'all don't mind. As y'all enter in, have the likes match the bodies that is up in here. Is my thing. What's good, y'all? Shout out to the folks that's up in here already. What's good to everybody? Hey, y'all. Hey. What is tea, friend? Child, we about to find out what the tea is when we dig into some of these gossip blogs, child. We're gonna find out what the tea is. What's good, y'all? Yes. Y'all know I gotta give time to let the folk in, so y'all know I get started around the 10-minute mark. I don't think I'm gonna wait until the actual 10 minutes, because I just don't think I am. Because I'm not going to be up here too long. Maybe about 45 minutes, an hour. You know what I mean? This is something new that I'm going to be doing up here because I'm seeing other folk doing it. And considering that y'all see ain't much TV for me, I don't mind dropping a show like a bad habit. But see, I can't keep doing that. If I want to stay scratching and surviving on YouTube. So I gotta have some things set in place for when the show gets tired, delayed, and through, and I want to review them up, and something can take that spot. I get the notification through my Gmail before it comes to YouTube. They need to do better. I agree. I try to tell y'all, make sure when y'all do that to hit all. If you want a notification bell, just make sure to hit all. I do know if you do personalize, it isn't going to give you everything versus when you hit all, you'll get everything. You know, even when I post a community, something on a community wall to a short to whatever, you're going to get it. But if you do personalize, you're not going to get everything. If that's the case, because I don't know. You like? Good. I'm glad you did. What's good, everybody? Hey, April. Hey, Autumn. Shout out to y'all. What's good? What's good? 80s babe, Ebony 80s baby. What's good, boo? All my mods in here. I see some members or whatever. If y'all haven't thought about subscribing to the channel, I mean, joining the channel, you should. What's good, y'all? Y'all come in. What's up? What's up? What's up? Hey, y'all. What's good? What's good? Hey, what's good, y'all? Let's see, we 5 minutes and we're actually about to be 6 minutes in. It's 58 people in here, which is fine. Y'all just make sure to lock up the lab, y'all. All right. That's all I want. You said, all right, you switch from personalized to all. Yeah, that's the best way of doing it. Because if you do it personalized, you're not going to get everything. So yeah, for those that, you know, been asking and been sharing y'all grievances about that. YouTube finally explained it to me when I emailed them about that, and then they finally told me to make sure that y'all hit all and not personalize. So, see, that's what they say. So, we'll see. Yes. Like I said, if you, those of y'all that would like to join, consider it. Please feel free. I have two tiers. 199 tier, 599 tier. I appreciate the T subs and squad that do follow and do that for me every month. It is greatly appreciated. Thank you guys. Those of you guys that would like to donate, the PayPal is available, the Cash App is available, and also if you would like to do super chat, super thanks, anything like that, it is greatly appreciated. Speaking of which, shout out to hold on. Shout out to, well, Autumn now, because Autumn just sent me some. Shout out to you, Autumn. Thank you for your Cash App. And thank you for the Nurses Week. I appreciate you. And also shout out to Muriel. Muriel. I hope I said your name right. Shout out to you, Muriel, as well for your Nurses Week Cash App. It was appreciated, boo. Thank you so much for that. And thank you again, Autumn, for your Cash App, boo. Anybody else that would like to donate, please feel free. Let's see, we 7 minutes and 50-some seconds in. All right. How do you become a member? Hit the member button. Go to the channel page and you'll see join channel. If you go to the main page, you should see it beside the subscription button. It'll say join, and you just follow what it says. Is that how it still works up here? I don't know. Let me see. Hold on. Let me make sure before I tell y'all. Hold up. Hold on. Let me go to somebody else that got a little joint thing. Yeah, that's how it goes. It should be right beside there. You'll follow it. It'll show you. What's good, y'all? What's good? What's good? We 8 minutes and 45. We're about to be 9 minutes, so. Forty-five likes to 64 people. I need at least 60 likes, y'all. I need 60 likes. I told y'all, I need as many likes as possible. Keep me in the auger. All right, keep me in the auger. And the only way to do that is to like. All right. You know what? I've actually been thinking about doing more lives. Like I've been thinking about doing like my reviews live, things like that. I don't know. I just feel like maybe doing lives would be a lot more beneficial as far as the algorithm goes versus pre-recording. You know what I'm saying? Or whenever I can. Because y'all know I be busy. I ain't got time to do lives, you know, all the damn time. But, you know, I do feel like I'm going to start maybe in the summertime. Most of the reviews will probably be a live. Not an hour live either, maybe 30, 45 minutes, something like that. All right, here I go. What's good, you guys? What's good, Miss Bella? I'm doing good, baby. How you doing? Hey, Terrence, this is your biggest supporter in Minneapolis. Hey, boo. Can you give me a shout out? This is Edwina. Hey, Edwina, how you doing, love bud? Yes, go laugh whenever. We love you too. I appreciate that. I love y'all too. Thank you guys. What's good, y'all? What's good? So more people are gonna enter in soon. Because I made this hours ago. So more folk gonna enter in. Y'all know how it go. It's only 2:30. So folk gonna come in on their lunch and all the rest of that stuff. Which is good. See, that's what I'm here for. Entertain. yes, yes. So listen, y'all, this is a new thing that I'm doing again, I say, and it's called Less Gossip, Child. And I just figured that this'll Oh, my bad. This is something new that I wanted to start to give you guys. What's good, Marcella? You here? I know that's right. What's good, boo? Anywho, this is some. I'm well working in NY. I'm in NY too, girl. What part of NY you in, child? I'm in Boostoir ass Long Island. Ain't shit around here, girl. Anyway, this was something new that I wanted to do because, like I said, I'm seeing a lot of other bloggers like dip and dibble and dabble into, you know, the blogging spaces or whatever the case may be, just to get a small little two senses and whatnot. And I just felt like, you know, that's interesting. Why not? I did it one time before, and the laugh got decent. Numbers, a damn show could have been better, but for what it was, it's passable. So I just figured this is something that I do again, maybe once every week or once every 2 weeks or something like that, or maybe every damn week. I don't know, depending on how well it do. So the outlets that I'm choosing to use for this, and I'm going to skip from back to back, is the Jasmine Brand, the Neighborhood Talk, the Shade Room, maybe the Shade Room Teams, but I don't really know what these little teeny boppers got going on, child, so I may just leave it the Shade Room. And Gossip of the City T. Those are the 2-4 outlets that I wanted to do. I'm not doing Hollywood Unlocked, because y'all know I do not fool with that Wisdom Tooth shape ass Jason Lee. I don't fool with her, and I ain't giving her no click or no view. So yeah, that's dead. But these are the 4 outlets that I'm choosing to get these ones from. And if y'all find any more other outlets or whatever the case may be that get some good stuff, y'all let me know. Now, let me see what I can find. The first one I'm going down to now is the Jasmine Brand. Because most of this stuff I really don't want to talk about. You said Wall Street. I'm screaming. What? Master P shows support of Mystical, calls for rapper to be released from jail following RAPE charges. It looks like hashtag Mystical definitely has at least one person rooting for him amid his current legal troubles. According to reports, hashtag Master Hips, Bike, and Body paid homage to his former artist by playing his hit song back in 97, The Man Right Here, during his recent performance at the Las Vegas hashtag Lovers and Friends Music Festival. In addition to playing the throwback track, Master Legs, Hips, Bite, and Body. Real name, Percy Robert Miller. See, y'all know, the motherfuckers that be so damn hood be having the most sissified ass names. Percy. You know, who the heck, could y'all ever imagine getting bullied or being talked about or you being chased home from a nigga named Percy? I guess, child. Anyway, called Mystical's release, and he said into the mic, "Free Mystical." The 53-year-old then encourages concert goers to also support and said, "Y'all, I get y'all hands up for my dog." You may recall that Mystical, born Michael Teller, is currently behind bars without bond in Louisiana as he awaits trial for a RAPE and false imprisonment case. Damn, Mystical? As previously reported, Mystical 52 was arrested last July for first degree RAPE, false imprisonment, domestic abuse, battery, strangulation, simple robbery, simple criminal damage to property. He's being accused of physically attacking a woman, holding her against her will, and raping her in his residence near Baton Rouge. The New Orleans native trial was originally set to start next month. However, his attorney has requested a delay in the proceedings in order to generate an efficient defense for her client. I mean, if he didn't do it, then, and you got proof he didn't do it, then what do you need all of the special rah-rahs for? I mean, if you know he ain't do it, and you, whatever, I ain't legal fish. Moving on. As previously reported, this isn't the first time Mystical has been accused of AS or SA. Y'all know what that is. In 2004, he was sentenced to 6 years in prison after pleading guilty to S.A.N., a woman. Full story on the hashtag JasmineBrand.com. Dear Lord God Almighty, what the fuck you got going on? Michael Taylor, girl, I knew that you got accused of this before, but I ain't heard all of these other charges. First degree RAPE, false imprisonment, domestic ABUSE, abuse. Well, y'all, I can't say it, but y'all know I can spell it, but I can't say it. Strangulation. You around here fiber wiring hoes. Simple robbery, simple criminal battery to. Listen. I don't know what made it so simple. Listen, Percy, you got a lot of dinner, and the sad part about it is, Percy, you got daughters. And you got a granddaughter. I do know for a fact you at least got one. Romeo gave you one. And not only that, he's been charged and convicted about this before. I never understood. Listen, I get that's your dogs, that's your friend. But at the end of the day, you got to learn what side of the fence to be on. You got to learn what team to play for and bat for. The fact that you got your overgrown ass in front of these people in a concert talking about something how they need to release. I mean, listen, I guess. Now, listen, Mystical ain't never did nothing to me. I ain't necessarily got no problem with Mystical. You know what I'm saying? He ain't never snatched my damn goodies. You know what I'm saying? He ain't never false imprisoned in me. You know what I mean? And I got a couple of his albums. But at the end of the day, I got a lot of homegirls that are just that women that are friends. Plus, I got two nieces. And there's no way in hell that I'm going to get my overgrown ass on any platform talk about some free Mystical. Dear Lord, God Almighty. Oh, he got a problem. He do. He do. A huge problem. That new embalming fluid. I'm screaming. Yeah, that doesn't look right. It don't look right at all. It really don't. It don't look right at all. Mystical is a danger to women and to himself. I feel like heteros love Jason Lee more than the gays. Oh, look, the gag is I feel like more niggas love Vlad, and I don't understand why. So it's interesting that you brought that up because I feel the same way when it comes to all of these niggas still going to sit up amongst DJ Vlad. I'm gonna talk about that one day too. But that's ridiculous. My granddaddy best friend is named Percy. Child. Percy need to help his brother, don't he? Percy smoke. Oh, Percy smoking that new Obama. I'm screaming. I don't know what he's smoking, but he need to get his life together. Cause like I say, you got daughters and the granddaughters, and you up here talking about some free mystical. I know you lying. Don't get me wrong. I love Mystical too, but not with all this ish she got going on out here. Lisa Ray defends Chris Brown following reports of his recent altercations. Every time his name is brought up, he gets automatically blamed. Lord, when will Lisa Ray learn to shut the hell up? In a recent episode of Foxo's hashtag Cocktails with Queens, hashtag Lisa Benahoe Ray, shout out to Kaya, 55, defended hashtag Chris Brown, 34, as she and her co-host discussed the altercations he was recently involved in. At the start of the conversation, Lisa Ray asked, why he gotta chill? As previously reported, Chris Brown allegedly had a dispute with fellow singers Teyana Taylor, 32, and Ersha, 44, last week. The crazy ordeal kicked off after Chris reportedly screamed, fuck her, at hashtag Teyana Taylor during his Las Vegas birthday skate party on May 5th. I didn't know Chris Brown was a Taurus. Reports vary on why he yelled at a 1001 actress. However, Ersha came to her defense, which reportedly caused a bigger altercation. Allegedly, Chris and his crew got into a fight with Ersha outside of the establishment and left the Mabu singer with a bloody nose. None of the other entertainers have confirmed or denied those allegations. However, according to Lisa Ray, Chris Brown shouldn't be judged for speaking his mind to his friend, she expressed. What if he felt just like what he said? Fuck her. What if he felt like that? And he's saying that to his friend. She continued. What I don't like about this is every time we bring up his name, not us, but every time his name is brought up, he always gets automatically blamed because that's because he is that way. We know him to be that. So it got to be him, she added. That's what I don't like when people have that kind of stigma. Because I got that. It's quick for you to think, oh, well, Lisa Ray would have did that or Lisa Ray said that. And I don't like that because the very next time it could have been different, you blame me because of my past. Following the Teyana Taylor and Ursha incident, Chris made headlines once again for his actions. The No Air singer was spotted at the Lovers of Friends concert yelling at individuals backstage. Full story on thejasminebrand.com, which is true because I did hear that too. I saw somebody, one of my YouTube friends up here talking about how Chris Brown was in another altercation. Listen, in my opinion, I really feel like Lisa Ray just wanted it. That's all. Lisa Ray want to screw Chris Brown. That's why she don't mind taking up for him, even though she knows he's wrong as two left shoes. Let's just call a thing a thing. All right? Okay? Let's just call a thing a thing here. All right? Lisa Ray wants to knock boots with Chris Breezy, and that's why she's taking up for him, because that's always the case when it comes to these women that want to sit up and take up for shit like that. They want to fuck them. My thing about it is, Lisa Ray, girl, hush. Okay, Hirsch, because 9 times out of 10 he is the problem, and it is him. It's not because of his past. I don't think it has nothing to do with that. Especially, I mean, he did yell out fuck Teyana Taylor, and him and his crew did jump Ursha when Ursha was the one who allegedly threw the damn party for him in the first damn place. I mean, you acting as if somebody lied on Chris Brown. Ain't nobody told no lie on Chris Brown. That's what happened. He and his crew beat up Ho Usha to a bloody pulp, allegedly, because to let other news and outlets tell it, they ain't seen Usha with no bloody nose, no blood all over his stuff. It was a lot of people saying that can't nobody confirm that he was walking around with black eyes and all of the rest of this. And I'm going to tell you what. I was watching Zoe. And I do think, goddamn Zoe, and I do think Zoe is onto something. When he says that this could all just be a ploy in a scheme and a scam. And it very well could be. Like, I just feel like if that really did happen to Usha, and he did have all of this blood and all of this bloody gory mess after they got finished kicking a mud hole in him, somebody would have seen it. Like, I just feel like it would have been some evidence of it or something like that. And then it's like, that happened, and y'all saying that he had all of this done to him, but then he turned around and performed the same night. So it's just, it is fishy, but Lisa Ray, shut your ass up. Okay, Lisa Ray, shut your ass up. And a lot of the times, Lisa Ray, much like Chris Breezy, it do be you. Just saying. A lot of the times when people have went off on you, Lisa Ray, it was for a good damn reason. All right, it wasn't because of your past, so people just wanted to blame you. Like, nah, that wasn't what it was. So stop that. Moving on. Because I like Lisa Ray, but sometimes she get on my damn nerves. Moving on. Thank you. Who's this? Thank you, Karma. Thank Karma. Yeah, Karma. K-R-M-A. Yeah, Karma. That's the only way to spell Karma. Thank you, Karma, for your cash out, boo. Appreciate you, boo. Yes, for the lunch money. Lunch on you. You got that right. Soon as I finish this. Thank you, Puddin. Kim Zosiak Beerman, a.k.a. the Atlanta Hillbilly, reportedly in talks to join Real Housewives Ultimate Girls Trip. Kim Zosiak Beerman, finesse, because she's about to divorce his ass, is reportedly preparing to make her Bravo comeback. The former Roa star is in talks to join the Real Housewives ultimate girls trip, according to Et B. Scott. I know for sure Kim has already been pitched for the girls trip. The publication sources reveals they felt she would be an she would be amazing on the last girls trip, but it was already cast. I'm sure they're considering her for the next girls trip, and I know if she's offered to do it, she will take it. The insider says, sadly, this drama makes her have a huge storyline, and that obviously, and it's obviously attractive for reality TV. Kim's reality TV return coincides with her split from Corey Bierman and reports of her of their financial clapbacks. Would you tune in for Kim's comeback? Hell no. I didn't like the CD Atlanta Hillbilly on the real Atlanta Housewives. What the hell make y'all think we want to see her on Ultimate Girls Trip? I really want to know why people keep trying to throw the Atlanta Hillbilly a damn bone. That's what I want to know. Like, why they keep trying to throw her a damn bone? Let Kim fend for her. Let her go out there and find another rich man dick to go and hunch on like she been doing so she can make her money. We don't need Kim. We don't need Kim. We don't want Kim. Don't nobody like Kim. I don't know where people feel like folk like Kim. Girl, don't nobody like no damn Kim. Nobody. Don't nobody like no damn Kim. Like, out of all the people that y'all could have gotten for this, y'all gonna choose Kim. For what? I'd much rather y'all choose Lisa Wu. You know what I'm saying? Somebody like it. I don't want no damn Kim. Do people watch? Yeah, people watch the girls trip. People watch the girl. Listen, I tried really hard to watch Ultimate Girls Trip twice. I tried to watch it the very first season, and I couldn't do it. And I tried to watch this season because Candace and Tacky and Heather and Whitney and all of them was going to be up there. So I tried to watch it for that. And it's the same. I don't know what it is that's hanging me up about Ultimate Girls Trip, but it do. Maybe it's because all of the episodes come out at once. And maybe that's what it is. You know what I'm saying? Maybe that's what it is. I don't know. But I tried. I couldn't do it. It ain't my judge. I mean, it's cute. I like the concept. And I do feel like it's a good idea. I'm not saying it's a bad franchise, but I just can't get into it. If I recall, Kim always leaving the show. What is Kim? Okay. As I recall, Kim was always leaving the show. Watch less filming episodes. So why would she be allowed to come back on show? I don't know, Ken. I don't know. Beep beep toot toot beep beep hey toot toot ow beep beep hey toot toot. I could tell you were old school food. Talk about some beep beep toot toot. I watch Girls Trip. I like it. I don't know why people is trying to make fetch happen with Kim. Me either. I couldn't do it either. It's the chicks they've been picking. I mean, listen, I was here for it, even with it being Hosha and Candace and Tacky and Heather and Whitney. I was here for it. I felt like, oh, okay, cool. And then they had the other chicks from Miami and New York, I believe. And I said, all right, fine. But it's still just I tried, y'all. I really did, but I couldn't get into it. But y'all ain't here for Miss Kim being there. Y'all are not here for Miss Kim being there. I don't blame y'all. Anywhoozing. Next that we got on the Jasmine Brand girl. So this says Tory Lanez faces a minimum of 9 years after motion for a new trial in Megan Thee Stallion shooting case was denied. Sentencing scheduled for June 13th. Child. June 13th? Don't let it be a Friday the 13th. Oh, you really unlucky. The final decision regarding Tory Lanez's guilty verdict appeal has been made. According to Legal Affairs, journalist Megan Conniff, a court judge recently denied the Canadian musician's request for a new trial after he was found guilty of shooting hashtag Megan Thee Stallion in her hood. I mean her foot. Reportedly, Judge David Horford handed down the ruling yesterday, May 9th. Kenneth, I guess, who was present at the time of the ruling, reported. Hereford went through, Hereford, thank you, Marcella. Yes, Marcella, thank you for your cash app, boo. I appreciate you, love bug. Thank you. Hereford went through the seven main arguments from Lane's lawyers that diminished each one. He concluded there was no errors, but he also said even if he concluded each error exists, the errors didn't have material effect on the outcome of the trial to warrant a new trial. Listen, y'all, I ain't about to read all this foolishness. Basically, Tory Lanez tried to get up out of his foolishness and his shenanigans, and the judge basically came out and said, girl, bye, you shot that woman in her hoof, allegedly. I mean, her foot. And your Canadian ass is going down. And that's just what he said. And listen, I'm on the judge's side. I thought it was real. Because y'all know, I gag Megan like I say he shot her in the hood. That's really only because she calls herself a stallion. I like Megan. Megan has never done a goddamn thing to me. And I like a lot of her songs. You know what I'm saying? And it was really irking me how so many people was just refusing to believe that Tory short fuck ass Lanez could have ever done something like this to Megan. Tory. The same dude that don't mind going out here getting into whole ass fights, jumping people down to concerts, and so on and so forth. Look at what he did to Miss Alcina. And the bad part about it is, Tory was already on papers. He was already dealing with trials and court cases and so on and so forth, dealing with this Megan shit. And what did he go out there and do? Go out there and lay hands on Miss August. All because Miss August ain't want to say hey. That's how I know they hurt you. Listen, I ain't never seen no dude go out here and get so upset at another man not speaking to him that they ran out there and got into a whole damn fight. I ain't never seen it. Listen, the same, and I feel the same way about him and Prince. The same way Prince allowed him to walk up on him at a club and bust him in his shit twice and he ain't do a goddamn thing but take it to court. But yet you got Prince up here on Bad Boys trying to talk about he gonna beat ass and so on and so forth. Listen. Listen. It's not allegedly anymore. He was found guilty. Well, I'm just saying alleged because all the straight niggas gonna get up under my comments. He ain't did nothing. That ain't proved nothing. Duh. So I just figured to avoid all of that foolishness and calamity, I'm just gonna say alleged. All right. I agree with you though, friend. He did it. Ain't nobody told no lies on him. He did it. Ain't nobody told no lies on him. I'm on your side. He did it. But, Tory need to let that girl case. He's still trying to convince us that he's innocent. He do not pass and go collect $200. Right. If a witness get on the stand and you say you shot him, boo, you're going to jail. Right. I won't lie. I was nervous when I heard Jose Menezes, his lawyer, because Jose done got Casey Anthony and Aaron Hernandez. That's his lawyer, the lawyer that got because Casey Anthony did get away with murder. Guess she, I don't care what none of y'all say. That Caucasian woman got away with killing her damn toddler, and I felt that way since 2008, 2009 when me and Joe Sam, all right, because me and Joe Sam was watching that news coverage like we did when it came down to Conrad Murray murder trial against MJ. You understand? We was glued to that. And me and Joy Sand felt the same way. She got away with it. So maybe that's why he hired him. Because, you know, you got her off of killing her own damn toddler. So if you can get her off of that, surely you could get me off of this. It ain't funny. It's not funny. What's good, Dylan? Hey, y'all. It's been forever since I called a lab. Well, I'm glad you're here. Casey is guilty. It's a listen. Listen, don't let my mama hear you say that. Listen, my mama was a firm believer that her man, OJ, did not kill that white woman. And listen, when that happened, I was in elementary school. I remember the trial. That had to be about 96, 95, 96. So I was about third grade-ish. And my mama because my mama was a housewife. And the TV was glued because it was court TV back then. Max mama TV was glued every damn day to that trial. And I remember looking at my mama. I said, my girl, stop. That man did it. I said, my stop. I know you love you some OJ and you don't want to see no wrong in him, child, but he did it. He did it, girl. Like, let's not even go there. T. Prince can actually fight because it was confirmed that he beat up Chaotic Goons when he set him up and Chaotic didn't fight. I remember that. I'm not saying that he can't fight. What I'm saying is the reason why he didn't fight Tory is because that was his dirty piece of trade. And listen to me, and I want y'all to listen to me good. You can fight dudes that you don't know that ran up on you because I didn't agree with what Chaotic did, and I still didn't understand why Chaotic was so pissed at Prince. Now, when it came to that, I was on Prince's side. Them you could fight, but you can't fight a 4'6" short ass Canadian, they're calling it what it is, that walked up on you and punched you in your shit twice. I don't want to hear it. I don't want to hear it. He's such a joke. Like, boy, you have a history of putting your hands on people, but yet he wants somebody to feel bad for him. I agree. OJ interrupted the soaps. It was all on the channels, and interrupted the soaps, child. You've been watching Bad Boy Club, Texas. I'm going to get on that in a few, Dominique. I'm going to get on that as to why that's been late. Let me see. What else can I get? Is there anything else I feel like talk about on the Jasmine brand before I move to one more thing? Twitter reacts to Robert De Niro welcoming baby 7 at 79. Robert De Niro just announced the birth of his 7th child. The 79-year-old actor broke the news Monday during an interview with ET Canada, Entertainment Tonight Canada. When the interviewer inquired about De Niro's 6 children, he responded, 7, actually. I just had a baby, he shared. He did not disclose any further information regarding baby number 7 or the partner with whom he welcomed his newest bundle of joy with. What age do you stop having children? I wish. Like hell. God forbid something ever happened between my brother and my sister-in-law. And he meets somebody else. And he's 79 years old. And me and him 10 years apart. So if he's 79, I'm 69. 68 going to be 69, right? And I wish his 79-year-old ass will come to my 69-year-old ass telling me that I got another niece and nephew coming. Do y'all know? You said his oldest child is 51. So his oldest child is 51 and he got a sibling that was just born. You said probably by a black woman. Is De Niro still with a black woman? I don't know. Maybe. I didn't know look, I don't know nothing about Robert De Niro. I ain't even know he was with a black woman. So y'all telling me something I ain't know. I ain't know he was with a black woman. I don't follow the Caucasian actors and actresses like that. And not their personal life. I didn't know. I ain't know he had a thing for the jungle fever. Go ahead, Robert. Not even gonna lie. Robert De Niro in his prime was something serious. I mean, are you still in your prime at 79 making babies? Yes, he married to one for years. I ain't know. He got children too. Yes, he used to be married to a black woman. Well, is he still married to her or no? Dominique said, yeah, he loved the sisters. Okay, Caray said he divorced his black wife. Oh. His first wife is black and she was gorgeous. Oh, okay. He got jungle fever bad. He got jungle fever. He got jungle fever. He got jungle fever. Y'all remember that, Martin? Well, listen, I mean, hey. He used to mess with Whoopi. Whoopi. Whoopi Whoopi. The View Whoopi. Sister Act Whoopi. Ghost Whoopi. The Color Purple Whoopi. John. Listen, for a long time, I just felt like Whoopi is dyking. You know what I'm saying? That's really what I think. I've always felt that way. Even when I was a little girl, I really felt like Whoopi was a dyke then. So y'all sitting up around here telling me that she was with white men. I mean, maybe that can explain it, but I still think she dyking. Okay, that was just a cover up to keep y'all off her back. See, I can appreciate it. Whoopi know what to do to keep folk off her back. The first wife played on 227. Who? Not was it Rose? No, Rose was always the one in the window. Not Brenda. That was Regina. He allegedly was getting down with Naomi Campbell too. I know y'all lying. Nah, I believe Whoopi had her fair cut of niggas in her heyday. That's fine. Look, maybe she did, but to me, she gave dyke vibes. I'm just being honest. All right, I ain't trying to put nothing on nobody that ain't there, but that's what Whoopi always gave me. Like she just got, you know. But do your thing, Robert De Niro. I mean, I guess. Listen, your baby might come out looking like Dean and Dylan. Oh, all right. I told y'all, y'all hoes gonna learn about letting these old ass men keep their worms all up in you. Y'all gonna learn. Didn't Whoopi's daughter used to date Stevie J? Listen, y'all telling me stuff because I ain't never heard that a day in my life, so I can't confirm or deny that, friend. And I don't know. The lady who rejected Rose, her name was Tookie. Child. I mean, but hey, whatever. And look, I ain't having any of it. This the last thing, and then we gonna move to another outlet. Hold on, do I got it up here for this? I think I sure do. Let me play it again because it was short. Let me play it one more time for the folk in the back. Bootsy backdoor booty bust the badass admits to masturbating in an airline bathroom while discussing designer's incident, indecent exposure arrest. Bootsy backdoor booty bust the badass recounted a personal experience while discussing designer's incident, indecent exposure charge after masturbating on a flight. So this backdoor booty buster talking. So he just went dumb. Boosie asked on a black again. These folks stick whatever. Boosie asked on a Vlad TV. Whatever. Cause Vlad, the only person I wanna that want to interview his ignorant ass. So I guess Boosie. A, did he go head up with the flight attendant? Oh, he just jacked off. Oh, he effed up. He need to go to that effing hospital. I eff with designer, but he need to take his ass to the hospital. My dick get hard on a plane. It was a long plane ride. My dick get hard on a plane too, he added. Go jack off in the bathroom. I've done it before. Go jack off in the bathroom. I was watching Twitter one day. That bitch was, man, I was on Twitter. I went and hit my shit in the bathroom. I'm reading it the way they wrote it. All right. That's how they wrote it. That's how I'm reading it. Designer announced his intentions to go into a mental institution late last month, just days after speaking up about his troubles while performing abroad. On his Instagram story, the rapper expressed regret for his conduct on the aircraft before admitting he has not been okay for the past several months. I'm telling y'all, Boosie is an old queen from back in the, and I'm gonna tell you why, what confirmed it for me. Just recently, anybody that watched Desi Banks, shout out to Desi Banks. Desi Banks did a small little short with Boosie. Why ain't none of y'all tell me Boosie was not only bow-legged but pigeon-toed? Most of the niggas I know that's bow-legged and pigeon-toed be putting their footprints on ceilings and or putting other men's footprints on ceilings or vice versa. They flip-flop or whatever they do. And now it all makes sense. Like, I was sitting, like, first of all, why did that have to be a part of your interview? Why does what designer had going on the airline, jacking off, what does that got to do with Lil Backdoor Booty Buster Badass and his music or his movie or whatever he got going on? Like, I'm not understanding. Can somebody help me understand what designer had to do with the Bootsy interview? And even that, Bootsy, why did you even have to admit that your nasty ass was over here jacking off on somebody, Spirit Airlines? Like, that is just so, listen. Say that 10 times fan, Boosie. He saw Piccolo Nas and he had to release himself. I mean, I could see what Boosie is saying in case you was that damn horny. Go take care of the bathroom like a normal person would. That's fine. But Boosie didn't have to add in, well, I've done it too. I've been there before. And another thing, my thing, and I don't understand why these niggas keep going to DJ Vlad. I don't know why. I don't know why they keep giving him interviews. Because if it was me, I would have been like, well, Vlad, that's designer. That ain't got nothing to do with me. I don't care why he went over there and beat his dick on the plane. I didn't do it. I don't care. Like, what that got to do with me and my interview and what I got going on? I mean, that would have been my thing with Vlad. Like, that ain't got shit to do with me. I don't know why he did that, but that ain't none of my damn business. That ain't got nothing to do with me, bruh. Like, that would have been my thing. Much like how, because he talked too much. And this is another reason how I know he get down with the get down. Much like how he was, I think he was on DJ Vlad when he said this about how he got locked up when he was locked up and he watched two niggas. He watched the nigga ride another nigga and he knew that one for him and da 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 da. But yet he was still sitting there watching. And I felt the same way then. I said, Boosie, we didn't have to know that, friend. We didn't have to know that, sir. That ain't our business. We didn't need to know that. We didn't need to hear about the one time you was in prison and you saw a nigga ride another nigga. And instead of you saying, ugh, that gay shit, get away from me, you watched. Again, you talk too much. Homegirl, you never shut up. Like, whatever. But I will say this, though, designer. I mean, for me, I would have loved to have seen it, but I'm gay. Boosie is not, allegedly. So, I mean, because you know, to me, she trade. I'm just saying. To me, she's a big old trade queen. But yeah, you finally caught me live, friend. TMI, Boosie, keep it to yourself. He always got to make it known that he's straight, but I can't tell. I'm just saying. I don't put nothing past him. Ain't this the same man who said he would let his 12 or 13 year old son get a lap dance from a stripper? He's trash. Let him. It happened. You don't remember how he said he let a stripper suck off his, I think he was 17 at the time. And then the nephew was like 12, 11, 12, 13, something like that. It was one of the two. And that happened already, friend. Where you been? The ones always screaming they straight be the ones that love men the most. Oh, girl, you know I know. We call them trade in our world. So you're right. Okay. We call them trade in our world. Krishan claims she and Blueface planned her pregnancy. We should have never planned it. In case you're keeping up with Krishan and Blueface, the mother-to-be is sharing news regarding her pregnancy. Despite the headlines across the drama, the reality star says that she and her on-again, off-again boyfriend planned her pregnancy. I do, but listen, a lot of people don't want to believe Krishan because of what they see on Zeus. And I get it, because when we constantly see her drinking, we constantly see her drunk, we constantly see her being a drunken, slobby fool, you know, in front of people, on camera, off camera, so on and so forth. People don't want to believe her. People just think she's batshit crazier than a bag of hammers and all outdoor. And she is. But I believe her. I believe Krishan. Listen. I've been gay all my life. I had my first boyfriend at 18, and I just been dealing with dudes ever since. Okay, so I know how dudes are. All right, and let's not sit here and act like these niggas will not sit here and pillow talk in your ear, gently caressing your ear, caressing your hair, and oh baby, you know I love you. You know you my baby. You know you mean the world to me. You gonna have my baby. You wanna have my baby? Come on, let me give you what you want. Let me give you my baby. And then the minute that it happens, then it becomes, well, we ain't playing that. That ain't my baby. You've been screwing around. You've been this, you've been that. So I believe Krishan. What's good, Harold? How you doing, friend? I believe Krishan. Even though I'm over them, I believe her. I believe every word of what she say. I believe her. You ain't lying. Yeah, I know. Shaking my head. No, I didn't know it actually happened. What? The Boosie thing? Yeah, that actually happened, friend. He admitted it, and he stood 10 toes down in what he did. And I remember the mama and everybody came out like they was fierce about that, but he ain't found nothing wrong with it. Yeah, baby, that didn't happen. There's something that draws me to that little girl. I really root for her. I want to root for Krishan too. I really do, because to be real, I really don't feel like she's a bad girl. I don't. I just feel like she's been through a lot, and she's rough, obviously, and she likes the attention of the roughness. But I think this baby was really sent to her to save her life. That's really what I think, because Krishan is rooted in church. Y'all know she coaches. Baby, let me tell you something. When her sister gave that nasty-ass prayer on their reality show before the whole melee happened, before, you know, he beat up her daddy, baby, she gave her old nasty Koji prayer, had Krishan sprawled out all over the concrete. So I my personal opinion, I think that baby would sit here for one thing, to save her life. That's what I think, and I'm gonna hold on to that until I find out otherwise. Same T. That's so true, T. Ninjas be out here lying. Yes. Boosie needs to just to admit that he be in those Hollywood parties. You talk about the ones Cat Williams said that he saw. I ain't even gonna do that. I feel bad about that baby. God bless the child that got his own. Okay, Gwendolyn. Yeah, so true. Y'all like up this video, child. 110, I appreciate it. I root for her too. She has so much talent. She does. He watched 2 minutes. Yeah, girl, he was in jail. He talked about a time when he was in jail, and that was the first time he saw two men have sex. And he said that the man was riding the other man, and he watched. And everybody's whole thing was, well, if it was so nasty and so gay and so faggoty, then why would you watch from beginning to end? So you watched the man put the condom on. You watched the man spit on it. You watched the man lube him up good. You watched the man sit down on it. You watched the man bounce on it. You watched the man come, but you didn't like it. It won't your thing. Got to pick up my nephew from practice. Aye, Lisa. I'm glad you was here, boo. He's already threatening to call children's services before the baby is born, child. Quashawn better than me because that baby would have been sent back to Jesus because that baby about to be raised in nothing but toxicity. You ain't lying, Dylan. Dylan, you ain't lying. Y'all know I ain't necessarily saying I go up for abortions, but considering I had one after 2 weeks, who am I to judge? Moving on. Tiger Woods accused of sexual harassment by ex-girlfriend. Tiger Woods is being accused of sexual harassment by his ex-girlfriend, Erica Herman. That's what you get for running around here with all these Caucasian women. According to court documents filed Friday, May 5th, Tiger Woods, 47, is being accused of pursuing a sexual relationship with Herman, 38, when she was working at his Florida restaurant, and then allegedly forced her to sign a non-disclosure agreement in order to keep her job. Erica Hartman's attorney, Benjamin Holders, wrote in filing, Tiger Woods, the internationally renowned athlete and one of the most powerful figures in global sports, decided to pursue a sexual relationship with his employee, then, according to him, forced her to sign an NDA about it or else be fired from her job. When he became disgruntled with their sexual relationship, he tricked her into leaving her home, locked her out, took her car, pets, and personal possessions, and tried to strong-arm her into signing a different NDA. Now he wants to deny her access to the courts and put his case into secret arbitration based on a highly redundant document or redacted document that he claims is a contract between them. The documents also describe a scheme in which Hartman claims Woods tricked her into leaving his home by telling her to pack for a weekend trip to the Bahamas. Upon arrival at the airport, Woods' lawyer met her and allegedly informed her that she was locked out of the house and would not see Woods again. The filing reads. While still in the hangar, Ray Donovan, a fictional character with a pen. I'm not even about to do that. Listen. She just mad because he dumped her. Oh, so y'all don't believe this woman is what I'm gathering. Y'all don't believe her? Oh, they're talking about Tiger up and ship him out of here too. It's called the breakup. She just mad because he dumped her. Why someone got to trick you to leave their house? So y'all don't believe her. Well, let me see if the comments believe her, because y'all not buying her story at all. Let me see what the comments say. Who wants something from the gas station? She's stupid. As you can see, he didn't learn from his ex-wife. Enjoy those women that keep you in the media sipping juice. Blah, blah, she's looking for money. He really doesn't learn, don't he? I thought we traded him in the racial draft. I'm screaming. Damn, they let these women say anything is sad. Bitter Betty, shaking my hand. When these men are going to learn, stop setting yourself up for them to lie. How did he force her to sign? These women are always suing men with money, but what about the ones that are not rich? Gets dumped and now you want to get paid. Should have stayed while you were there. Tiger need to learn from all of these people. give your money to a sister. I'm on your stab with that. Yeah, well, it looks like a lot of people don't believe her either. It looks like a lot of people do not believe her either. They are not on her side. They think she a lying half. I don't know. Okay, I don't know. But I do agree with the people when they say, Steve, you just need to go with a sister. See, a sister ain't even going to go through all of this because a sister going to already have a buku of your money stashed in her titty somewhere. You understand me? Or stashed in her mama titty somewhere. And stashed in big mama titty somewhere. You know what I'm saying? Like, so see, a sister, we wouldn't even go through all that. I don't believe her. He told her to leave. I don't believe her. A sister would lie to stop it. Child, well, I'm sorry, Miss Caucasian lady, but the folk ain't believing. Okay? The folk ain't believing you, Puddin'. One day he'll learn that the grass ain't always green on the other side. That part. Come on, friend. Good diggers come. Gold diggers come in all shades. I mean, yeah, they do. They do. This sounds like fiction, but I'm not mad at her for trying to squeeze his pockets. I mean, I ain't mad at her for trying to squeeze his pockets either, but she could find another way to squeeze it. Not sit over here and lie on this man, and they could really, like, take this man freedom. That I'm not here for. You know what I mean? I ain't here for that. Now I'm down for squeezing a man about his coin, but not at the expense of his life, child. No way. Girl, what did y'all think about the Brat's performance? I got to play it like this. What did y'all think about the Brat's performance recently? I think this was also at the Lovers and Friends concert where Ursha got, y'all know, I ain't even finna do that to Ursha. That's the Brat. She performing. And a lot of people was like giving her hell. The comments said, we have Rihanna to thank for this trend. Somebody said, somebody else said, why? Who said this is the outfit? Who said, yeah, this one? Who? Somebody else said, out of breath on that, she got the people talking. Excellent PR strategy, especially for the new show. I agree. This was actually very cool. Sis is tired. I'm sick of seeing this outfit. I remember how I was short of breath a lot by just walking when I was that far along with my son. So shout out to her. I have nothing to say. Was the cutout really necessary? This outfit, winded as fuck. Working while pregnant isn't for the faint. I had no idea the comments was going to be like this. My plate is full. Me too, Mike. Okay. Girl, what? Whose idea was this? What is the meaning of this? The baby throwing his fist up in the air. I'm so screaming. I'm not doing shit at 40 weeks pregnant. I hate it for her. This is so sad. Lord, y'all just giving Shantae the blues. Listen, let me tell you something. I'm all down for the Brat still working, even though she's pregnant. People do it all the time. All right. Beyonce performed during the Oscars about 6 or 7 months pregnant with them damn twins. All right. And ain't nobody said nothing to her. So don't nobody need to be saying nothing to Shantae. All right, I'm on her side. If you can work, work. A lot of these celebrities get pregnant and still do it. Beyonce did it. Hell, Whitney Houston did it. Whitney Houston was pregnant with Bobby Christina doing the I'm Every Woman video. All right, like, she did it. Like, so many, like, can we not do that? Leave Brett alone. All right, because that woman is already pregnant. All right, she ain't used to that before. All right, because y'all know she a dyke from way back. She ain't used to being pregnant, being winded every day, being uncomfortable every day, pissing every 5 minutes, eating everything out of house to home, being winded, just taking 2 steps. And then I'm more than sure she said, girl, y'all want me to perform for this? Well, listen, I want to be comfortable. So if that means having my belly out for me to be comfortable, then that's just what I'm going to do. Like, y'all leave Shante alone. Now, was I here for the outfit? No. Okay. No, I was not here for the outfit at all. But I ain't finna sit over here and read Shante down, girl. That girl did the best with what she had. Y'all let her be. I'm sorry, I like the brat, but she be looking tacky sometimes. The woman is pregnant. Get her a break. All right? Is the brat still making music that folks want to hear? Girl, I don't know. I think the brat is old as she is. She could provide her for Moses something else, child. Her wife, I made it. You think so? She said she didn't know the shirt was going to be cut out. And that was her wife's last minute idea. Well, you don't need to listen to Big Booty Judy no more, because I really won't hear for the cutout. So I ain't going to lie. I did not like the outfit. Now, Brett, what you could have came out, Brett, you could have did what all of the folk did back in the 90s when they was pregnant, but they still had to tour or do a performance or a video shoot. Wear some overalls, girl. That's all you had to do. All you had to do was put on a So-So Def t-shirt or one of your old DeBrat tour t-shirts or something like that, put you on a nasty piece of overall with one strap on, some Tim's or some Nikes or some flip-flops, put you on a hat. That's what you do, Brat. That would have suited you a lot better. Child. Okay. That's what you do, Brat. See, that's what the girls used to do back in the 90s when they was pregnant. They just put on some overalls and call it a day. Boom. Everybody know you're pregnant. Or they put on like a big, overly long ass sweatshirt or something. Support a HBCU. Put on a Spelman sweatshirt, but have about two sizes too big. You know what I'm saying? Something like that. That's what you do. She said it on the morning show. Right. The jean jumper would have been super cute. It would have been. Get you a nasty set of Oshkosh bagosh and you would have been just fine. Girl, get you some Oshkosh. All right. I'd have came out there in my Oshkosh with a t-shirt on. Oh, you ain't even need a t-shirt. You could have just put on a sports bra. With a pair of Oshkosh. One of the things on, the other one down with some Tims. There you go. You'd have been looking like TLC. And you'd have been right there with the folk. And everybody would have went up. Ciao. Anyway, I'm going to leave her alone. Y'all, why ain't none of y'all tell me this, girl? Jennifer Hudson is open to doing a versus against Fantasia. Why ain't it? Now, listen. Jay Hood, scream of her. You know I love you, girl. Listen, I've been here for Jay Hood since her album first came out because I did not watch American Idol. I got Jay Hood's first album and the second one. I listen. I love me some Jay Hood. She has sang her face to the floor. She has sang under the benches. But do I feel like you have enough hits to go up against Fan? Nah, I don't. Let me see. What type of hits Fan got? And I ain't the sad part about it is, Jay Hood, I ain't even talking about the radio cuts. I'm talking about the unknown cuts that you will only know if you was a fan of Fantasia and you know what I'm saying? You got all her out. I mean, Free Yourself, Truth Is, Got Me Waiting, I Believe, You're Always On My Mind was a good song. That's off the first album. Then you got Hood Boy. This is the second album. You got Hood Boy, When I See You, I Nominate You, Only One You, I'm Not That Tight, 2 Weeks Notice, Surround You, then get down to Fantasia, Back to Me. This is the third album. You got I'm Doing Me, Bittersweet, Man of the House, Collard Greens and Cornbread, Even Angels, Then you get to the side effects of you. You got Ain't All Bad, Without Me with Kelly Rowland, Lose to Win, Lighthouse was a good song, In Deep was a good song, Side Effects of You was one of my favorite songs. I think I said that. But let me see what J-Hud got, because I ain't even finna do J-Hud like that, because again, I love her. Because Jennifer Hudson got some stuff. Let me see her first album. She got Spotlight, If This Isn't Love, Pocketbook, My Heart, and I Am Telling You. And then her second one, she got No One Gonna Love You, and that's the only song that I got from that because I really didn't fool with her. I mean, listen, J-Hud, I would be here for it just because it's you and just because it's you and Fan. I would be here for it, but let me tell you something, J-Hud. Do not go into that versus thinking that you're going to win. Okay? That's all I ask, J-Hud. Listen, J-Hud, Fantasia's second album is enough to blow whatever you got out of the water. All right? I'm just saying. Even I'm telling you, no shade. You say you like J-Hud, but you don't know her music. I do. I got both her albums. And I think I got about three albums. I think three studio albums. I only got the first two. So now her first album, I actually listen. And I it's a lot of songs up there that I like. But not against Fan. All right, J-Hud. Not against Fan, baby. Please don't go up against Fan. All right. Who would I put Fantasia up against? Not J-Hud. who would I put her up against? That's a good question. Nat J. Hood. I don't know. Who would I put? I don't know who I put Fantasia up against. I don't know. I got to think about that. Nat J. Hood. I'm asking y'all, who would y'all put Fantasia? Jasmine. Listen, I love me some jazz. I love me some jazz. But no, not even Jasmine could go up against Fan. All right? I love me some jazz. But not even she could go up against Fan. Don't get me wrong. I loved her first album. And I did love Reality Show. But do I think that's enough for her to go up against Fantasia and take Fantasia out? Uh-uh. I don't know who. Hits or vocally. Well, listen, the only reason why I'm saying this, y'all, is because I actually listened to their albums. All right. I didn't just listen to the songs that came on the radio and I like them. I have the albums and I listen to them. You know what I'm saying? So that's why I'm basing it off of it. And considering that, Jasmine can come close to Fantasia, but do I think that it would be good though. I give it that much. It'll be good. Hey, Deidre, what's good, baby? Take a poll. All right. All right. We'll take a poll. What do y'all think? Hold on. Let me see if I can do it up here. I think that's how they spell the verses. Fantasia. Well, let me not put J-Hud. Let me put. Should I put that? Yeah. Because I was just going to put J-Hud, but. Nah, because then people going to be like, who the hell is J-Hud? So, nah, let me just say Jennifer Hudson. Well, there go y'all poll. That's for y'all to decide, child. But for me, I ain't mean to sue J-Hud. Well, yeah, J-Hud, because J-Hud said that she would go up against her. So that'll be for y'all. Who do y'all think will do it? Because for me, I got Fantasia all day. No shade, Jennifer. Because I live for you, baby. Let me see. Is there anything else that's girl, I'm getting over this whole Jamie Foxx thing because don't nobody seem to really know the truth at this point. So I'm not even about to bring Jamie Foxx up in this. I really wish they would just allow Jamie Foxx to just get better. All right, that's what I'm gonna say. I wish they would allow him to just get better. Stop coming out here with all of these stories. 5 minutes later, oh, he's doing good. He's on a track to recovery. Then 2 seconds down the line, he's great. He's in grave danger, and we got a whole bunch of priests that's surrounding his bed. So it's just I'm not dealing with that. I'm just keeping him in my prayers because I love me some Jamie Foxx, and I think it is real messed up that these people trying to unalive him. And when I say these people, y'all know who I mean. Valentina says she felt betrayed by Portia Williams when she got into a relationship with her ex silverback, Simon Gubadia. We were cool. I wouldn't do that to another one. So apparently her and Miss Jalen that found their way to MTV's couple retreat. And this came up during the couple's retreat. And, you know, she's real hurt by Portia and so on and so forth. And I'm just like, girl, you still on that? Listen, this is what I got for you, Fal. All right. This is what I got for you, girl. Let Hosha have that damn silverback, girl. You didn't have no business being with him, and that's why God allowed that to happen. Listen, sometimes God is sitting here trying to tell you apart from things that you keep trying to keep in your damn life. And maybe this is what you needed, Fallon. All right, I'm just going to be honest, because he ain't no good man. Any person that could have done that to you, Fallon, is not a good man, and you didn't need him in your life to begin with, child. So I don't even know why you still mad and upset with Portia, child. Portia gonna get hurt. See, what you put out there is what you get back. We say it all the time. Karma is a real thing. I don't even know why you sitting around there worried about a girl. Child. You should have been more concerned about that sissy that you decided to turn into trade and have a damn baby die. Moving on. Jocelyn Hernandez and Amber Baldine Rose get into a fight in the upcoming season of College Hill, child. Look at this foolishness, child. Girl, look. Y'all see it? Girl, would you look? Look at it. Hold on. Look at that. I'm trying to show y'all. Would y'all look at that? Well, child, who y'all got winning the fight? Do y'all got Jocelyn Hernandez winning it? Or do y'all got Amber Baldine Alopecia Rose? Y'all let me know down in the comment and I'm going to move on since I did put that alopecia joke out there and I'm just going to braze on back like I ain't say it. Oh, now YKO trying to shoot his shot at Resume, child, at Resume Carter. Because y'all know her and Armand is still on this fake-ass BS that they got going on. Because I hear both of them are on a reality show. And I think that's why all of this is going on. And But they ain't together now, apparently. And so now YK Osiris, aka YKO, is now trying to shoot his shot down to Reginae with his cute ass. Sitting over here, he put at Reginae Carter. Hold on. What happened? Wait a minute. At Reginae Carter, it's okay. You are a beautiful woman and you should always speak your mind, especially when Lane's making you look bad. All right, YKO. All right, YKO. All right, now. Listen, he and his brother Trey are a package deal. And you light skin and you a pretty boy. So, I mean, I'm just saying. I'm just saying. Please be careful, YKO, because you cute. I don't, you know. Okay, because them brothers, you understand me? It, you know. I thought he was one of the gruffs. No, that won't him. Trey. You talk about his brother, Trey. Trey, one of the gruffs. All right? And I don't care what Trey tell y'all. I don't care how many baby mammies he run out here and get. Trey is the trade piece. Not Armand. Okay? What? Stars come to Babyface's defense after Anita Baker gives him the boot at the recent performance. You deserve better. What? I'm truly sorry to my fans who have been waiting for us to hit the stage this evening at the center. I don't know that. I was asked not to perform in order to give Miss Baker her space and time to perform her show in its entirety. My band and I extremely saddened we didn't get to perform for y'all tonight. Oh, no. Anita. Now, Anita, I love me some Anita, but Anita is more than enough room and enough space, girl. And you could have gotten your set done without telling Babyface that he had to leave. Why you ain't let Babyface perform, Anita? Now, I love you, Anita. I mean, y'all know I ain't even finna read Anita down. I ain't, because she an elder. I'm respect my elders. My mama loved Anita Baker. Do you hear me? So I ain't even finna do Anita like that. But Anita, come on, boo. Now, that's just petty. Anita, that's petty. Damn, let Babyface perform. Anita, let Babyface perform. Dear God. What is exactly Reginae? What does Reginae do? I don't know. She Lil Wayne's daughter. That's the only thing I know. That's her only claim to fame. She Lil Wayne's daughter. She Toya Johnson Wright Carter, whatever her last name is, daughter. She was on Growing Up Hip Hop Atlanta. And then she was once an OMG girl for like 2 weeks. And other than being on these little BET Arabesque Tubi films, I mean, I don't know what Reginae do other than that. They say Anita been like that for years, child. Hey, friend, just popping in. Speaking of music, have you seen Janelle Monae's music video? No, I haven't. Hey, Ransom Rambles. And no, I haven't. Not yet. I love Anita. I love me some Anita Baker. All right, I'm not finna slander Anita Baker. I love me some Anita Baker. Y'all nuts? I love me some Anita. Ain't never no shade to Anita, but Anita don't need to be shading Babyface because I love Babyface just as much as I love her. And I know if I was there personally, I would have felt the way. Now I love you, Anita, but I would have felt the way if I paid money to see Babyface, but we couldn't see Babyface because you wanted to be a big baby and start crying over a damn set. Now, I love me some Anita. I ain't finna do Anita. But, now, we gonna be real. As much as I love her, we finna be real. Now, if I pay money to see Babyface also, I won't see Babyface also. I'd have felt the way. So it looks like Mimi and Stevie are back on good terms. I mean, I guess since, Ty don't want her ass no more, she want Drew. So I guess now she figured the only person that really want her in some type of way is Sleazo. So she decided to go back to Sleazo. Hey, they ain't none of my business. I say do what you do. Not Luma D. Child, Luma D just recently performed her old ass song that came out when I was a sophomore in high school back in 2004. Uh-oh. 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 Y'all remember that? If you want me to stay, I'll never leave. If you want me to stay, lovelessly. If you want me to stay, if you want me to stay, and I believe y'all remember that. She that came out and performed that old tad ass 10th grade high school ass song, girl. Y'all know that was the only hit she ever had. So I know it's just this only one set. But shout out to you though, Luma D. I ain't mad with you. I had her album, by the way. I did. I did. Don't listen. I did buy the Luma D CD only because I liked it, that song, and I couldn't find it in the single, so I had to settle for the album. And that I never listened to. I just listened to that song. That song was on repeat. That was my song. Child, Ty left her and Faith left him. I think they each other's permanent backup plans. Could be. Everybody's spinning the block on their old. Shut up, Harold. Was Nikki performing with her? Nikki did a song right into that beat. I think. I mean, I don't know. I didn't really pay that much attention to it. I was just gagging that it was Luma D. Okay. Because I told y'all, the last time I seen her, girl, I was in high school. Okay. Y'all here for it? Nicki Minaj says she's appearing on live stream with Castanet. Tells Twitch they better do right by him. Y'all know I live for Castanet. He is such a cute. I ain't finna play it because I ain't got time, but that's Castanet. There go Knick Knack Patty Whack. And I think Brooke was with her. That it looked like Brooke was with her when she was doing this. Brooke Bailey, it looked like her. I ain't know Brooke knew. I need to find the other picture that I'm telling y'all, that girl looked just like Brooke Bailey. But shout out to Castanet. I like Castanet a lot, his little cute head. Beyonce addresses fans who keep asking for Renaissance visuals. A queen moves at her own pace, bitch. Listen, look, Beyonce, and I love you down, baby, but let me tell you something. You're gonna work yourself to an early damn grave, child. Listen, the facts are the facts. Personally, I would have preferred a visual. I would have personally preferred visuals over another world tour, Beyonce, okay? All right, no shade. But see, you giving visuals and then you doing a visual album, see, that's more affordable for people on a YouTube slash nurse's salary like I am. Because if you think for 1 minute I was finna pay your already rich ass 2 stacks of my money to sit in a nosebleed section, more than likely, can't even see you good, and all of the rest of that stuff, girl, you done gone crazy. Personally, I would have lived for a visual album, much like she did on B-Day, and much like she did with the Lemonade album, even though I despise that album. I hate that album more than anything on this earth. But still, I would have appreciated that more, and so would a lot of other people, because that's in other people's price range. $2,000 just to see you bebop across the girl. Don't get out my face. And I love me some Beyonce, but Truth be told, her album didn't sell. It didn't sell that well. She got to make that money. Ooh. But the Beehive don't come for me because I didn't say that. Gwendolyn said it. Gwendolyn Crosby. Okay, she said it. She said that, not me. So don't y'all come buzzing y'all asses around me because I ain't say that. So Safari is shutting everybody up and being with his own damn churn instead of being seen carted out by Rolexes for the next bitch's churn. No shade to Amara, but Amara is, and I ain't even talk about this when this happened about 2-3 weeks ago. But I just find it real funny that now he wants to be seen with his children and he wants to be around his children and be on lives with his children and so on and so forth after you gotten called out for not doing for your children. But you can buy Rolexes for somebody else's term. And I really want to know how Amada Baby Daddy feel about her storyline, because that's what that is, buying expensive Rolex watches for his daughters. See, because if that was me, I personally would have felt the way, especially if you ain't even doing for your own damn churn. But you want to run out here and buy my churn expensive gifts like they ain't got a damn day. See, I would have felt the way about all of it. Amada, I feel the way about you. Safari, I've been felt the way about you. And this ain't even me taking up for Erica, but you don't get no cool points from me. I hate a social media dad. He's a clown. Right. Safari is a joke. He's been looking a fool since Nikki. Don't sick the Beehive on me. Nah, because they ain't come around here fooling with me. I ain't say it. I repeated it, but I ain't say it. Allen ain't a shit daddy himself to let Amada tell it. Well, listen, she left one ain't shit nigga to go with the next one. Because again, if I was Amara, I would feel away. I mean, I'd have been like, yeah, this is cute, but what have you done for your churn? Erica ain't lying on you. Like, that would have been my thing. Like, I really would have felt the way, like, I wouldn't have felt comfortable as a woman and a mother accepting that, you know what I'm saying, knowing where he got going. And another reason why I'm not with it is because, y'all, don't be fooled. He wants to stay a celebrity of any kind by any means necessary. So whoever he got to lay with that's on Love and Hip Hop, he's going to do. So, and that's another reason why I'm just side-eyeing Amara. Because Amara, you were sitting over here trying to act like you ain't like Safari. You don't want Safari. Safari is this, Safari that, blah, 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 blah. But now all of a sudden he tickles your fancy when the new season is about to come back out and y'all are filming for it. Okay. Whatever, friend. Ain't my baby daddy. I don't care. No shame, Selena Powell gives details about her sexual encounter with Lil Meech, claims she and her friend gave him head for 2 hours straight. Girl, I know you're lying. Video Selena Powell posted of her giving Lil Meech brain is from 2022. I just posted the full video of me and baby BMF. Did go crazy. Ain't he musty? Like, Didn't so many girls come out and said that he was musty and he smelled like onions? And Selena, what happened to the days when girls used to lie and deny even sucking dick? See, those are the days that I come from. I'm a gay boy of a certain age, okay? Back when I was in middle school, high school, and even college, you couldn't pay none of them girls to admit that they get a boyfriend head. Now it's just like it's what, like, Selena, what was your purpose of telling us that, friend? We don't care that you slobbed on this man's knob for 2 hours straight. First of all, who dick is you sucking for 2 hours straight? If it takes me 2 hours to suck you off, then girl, I don't want it. I'm busy. Okay, I got stuff to do. You and your friend sat in a dirty ass bathroom for 2 hours. Just, and you up here bragging about that? Y'all want to, and see, this is stuff like this is how I felt about when the Freaknik movie is supposed to come out, right? And there's so many women that was a part of that that's trying to stop that movie from coming out because a lot of them, I'm a mom now, I'm married now, I'm a pastor now, I'm a lawyer now, I'm a this now, I'm a that now, girl, oh well. Oh well. That's why your parents used to tell y'all, don't go out there and do nothing on camera that you would not do in private. And what y'all women go out there and do, and now y'all want to block stuff next, because see, Selena, this is gonna happen to her one day, because you gonna have a child, and God forbid one day your child decides, well, let me look at my mama and see what my mama had going on before I got here. So what your child gonna see? You in the bathroom on your knees for 2 hours sucking dick? I'm just saying, like, y'all girls ain't got no shame no more. No shame. And you know what I'm saying? Like, at least the girls in my generation lied about giving their man head. Like, y'all just, whatever. Nick Cannon says he decides which of his partners to sleep with based on who calls him that day. Neighbors, Mr. Super Sperm Cannon is letting y'all know he likes to be chased by his exes. According to Daily Mail, Nick did an interview with the Los Angeles Times, and they asked about his personal life, which he describes as an urban 50 Shades of Grey. Nick goes further into details about how he chooses where to sleep between all six of his baby mamas. A lot of times, it's whichever one of them calls me that day, to be honest. I'm just a creature of habit. I like who like me. Y'all want to know something? When I was a little girl, and Nick Cannon used to be on Nickelodeon, like when he was on... See, for y'all older folk, Nick Cannon started off on All That back in the early 2000s. Late 90s, early 2000s. That's how all of us got familiar with Nick Cannon. And I was so in love with Nick Cannon back then. Like, he was my absolute favorite on All That. When he had the Snick House on Saturdays, I had to watch that. It was a given. I watched that until the very last episode of that came on. And around that time, I was too old for All That and All That anyway. And I was busy with school and so on and so on. So, you know, you grow out of all of that. But I was in love with Nick Cannon, y'all, and I never would have thought that we would have been here in 2023, and I got to call him a fuck nigga. No shade, that's probably how the baby gonna be conceived, yeah. Guys used to hide the fact that they gave head until after Lil Wayne made a cue.
Okay.
Nick Cannon is weird. Very. I'm convinced that Nick Cannon made his personal mission to embarrass Mariah Carey. Well, why should Mariah Carey be embarrassed? She ain't with him no more. If I was Mariah Carey, I wouldn't feel embarrassed at all. If anything, I would feel relieved that I got that away from me. And if I was her, I would do some to keep him away from my children, because I just don't feel like, because my thing is, what are you teaching your children? You're teaching your sons it's okay to have a boo cooler, to have women or baby mamas out the afghan. That's what you're teaching your sons. It's okay to have 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 12, 13, 14, 15 baby mammies. That's what you're telling them. And you're also telling your girls it's okay to just be a man cum bucket. Basically, you're telling them it's okay to be a man's cum bucket. Whatever. Whatever. Out with the old, in with the new. Milan Christopher to replace Ray J as the Dosh Network CEO. It's a Dosh Network. I've never heard of that. DOSH. Is there such a thing? I've never heard of it. Milan Christopher had already launched his own network 3 months prior to signing onto the Dosh Network, the MC TV streaming network, that he then sold to the Dosh Network, along with a fully produced and edited show series called Hot Boys Atlanta. Within those 3 short months, his network has accumulated over 27K subscribers. Well, you close to me. With the success of Milan's seasoned network business model, Dashboard of directors decided that the business plan and model Milan Christopher created for his own network, for his own now network, would be a perfect fit for what the Dosh Network app plan business plan needs. Now, with the multimillionaire shareholder and investor, Milan says he looks forward to creating more fun-filled shows with different people from all walks of life and, of course, a little bit of drama that we all love to see on our TV screens. The Dosh Network app is now available in the App Store and Google Play services. I never heard of it. I never heard of it. And I have no plans of going to find out about it. It's something called the Dosh Network, y'all. It's over 27,000 subscribers. He along there with me. I'm 21,000. He 27,000. We close. They somewhere around there, girl. I mean, I guess, friend. I'm good on anything that Mother Mulan has to offer. I'm weak. I just Googled Dosh Network and found nothing. Just Dish Cable. You know what? Eddie Murphy has a slew of kids too. Well, that's Eddie. Okay? And Eddie can do whatever the hell Eddie want to do, because Eddie got it like that. All right? And we love us some Eddie. Eddie can do that. Not Nick. Moving on. Is there anything else? Because this is an hour now. It's almost two. And I felt like this is going on for a nice little minute. Let me see, is there anything worth talking about? I don't think so. Update, Trump found guilty of AS, will pay $5 million in damages. He needs to go to jail. Not pay $5 million. So moving on. Blueface captures aftermath of Krishan trying to set his house on fire. Child Protective Services is gonna have a ball with you, child. Krishan, not you pulling a Lisa Left Eye when it came down to Andre Rison. Get out of that mess, Krishan. You're pregnant. Dear God. But yeah, y'all, that's all I got for this segment. Because it ain't really nothing else going on that's talking about. Oh, but I did tell y'all I was gonna explain Bad Boy. The reason why y'all don't have a Bad Boys for me yet, y'all, is because I got completely disinterested and completely bored with it. And the reason why I did is because I don't like the jumping. I don't like the jumping. And as far as from what I see, all of y'all some scary ass hoes, other than Jonathan. That's the only thing that I gathered from this. Y'all are all scary. You're not gonna fight until you see somebody else fight, or y'all all are gonna rally up behind Jonathan. And that's boring to me. Okay, that's boring to me. Like, you got Chef B over here trying to jump on Banga once Banga and Big Lou done slapped Po Banga, child. And people went up for that slap. To me, that's some girl. I figure if you a man and you gonna slap another man, you may as well punch him. Like the whole, like I know y'all some sissies. But I ain't never seen Jonathan slap nobody. If Jonathan throw them blows, okay, Big Lou went around here slapping folks. And people went up for it. Whatever. But it's boring to me, y'all. It is. Ain't nobody in there bad. Nobody in there bad. Everybody in there scared of Jonathan. So they just gonna follow up behind how Jonathan feel, you know. Or if they are gonna fight, it's a jumping, and I don't like I ain't with it. I ain't with it. I don't get entertained by that. I don't get entertained by that. I mean, don't get me wrong, the slap was slapping, but I just feel like as a grown ass man, would I waste my time smacking you, or am I just gonna sleep your ass? I'm gonna go with sleep for 500, Alex. I'm not gonna waste my time being a grown ass man slapping. All right, I ain't finna do all that. Like, you another man like I am. Ball your fists up, bruh, and let's make this. Let's shake this boat the way it's supposed to get shook. I ain't gonna waste my time slapping. And then plus, I feel a way about Orlando Brown being up there. I ain't gonna lie. I feel a way about Orlando Brown being up there. I just feel like he's being exploited for our personal gain. And I just don't feel right. I'm just gonna be real. I don't feel right. If Orlando went up there, I probably would have went on ahead, but I just and because I just feel like him being up amongst all of that ain't gonna help him at all. Let me see what this poll talk about, y'all, because I ain't even look. Percent is for Fantasia. 11% is for J Hood. Well, at least J Hood got some people on her side that think she went. Same for Raz B. Yeah, I'm not including Raz B in that. All right, I'm not including Raz B in that. Now, don't get me wrong. I ain't saying what Raz B went through was, not as important, but I ain't add Raz B into that, child. No shade to Raz, and y'all may look at me funny for saying that, and that's just fine. But I'm not putting him in the category of mental illness as like Orlando Brown. I'm not putting him in that. Okay, I'm not putting him in that. Okay, Raz B just need to get over the, he needs to figure out how to get over the fact that, you know, they took his puss without his permission, allegedly. Allegedly. Because, I mean, you know. But I believe, look, I believe every word of what Raz B said. You know, Raz B was the one that busted out everybody. Raz B was the one who said that Lil Fizz and J Boog liked it. He said Lil Fizz and J Boog didn't have to be made to do it like he was, and all the rest of the, I'm saying what he said, okay? But I do believe, okay? He's saying Omarion ain't had to be forced into doing it. I'm saying what Raz B said, okay? I'm saying what Raz B said, okay? Raz B said he always felt funny about it. He always maintained that. He said he always felt funny about it. He really didn't necessarily want to do it, but he didn't want to not do it and mess up their stuff. So he had to be, it had to be some intensive for him to do it. But he said, Omarion, J Boog, Fizz, girl, they was all down for it. That's what he said. And Marcus Houston, he said that too. I'm saying allegedly, even though it came out of his mouth, I'm still saying alleged because it's a chance that this is going to come across these people's desk. And even though it came out of his mouth, I'm saying allegedly. I believe every word of it, but I'm still saying alleged. Chef, does Chef D call himself Orlando Brown bodyguard or something? I don't know what Chef D is, child. I mean, he's fine as hell, but he a big puss, in my opinion. And Jay Books are damn fine. Chris Stokes and MH ain't right. Speaking of Marcus Houston, he don't give a damn how y'all feel about his underage wife. Well, technically, she ain't underage now. But she was when they first met. And he already done came out and said on his uncensored, he don't give a damn how y'all feel. It is what it is. And it is what it is. And it is what it's going to be. He married her. That's his wife. They together, she aged now, and I think she just had a baby. So screw how y'all feel. That's what he say. And because of that, that is how I believe every single solitary word of what Raz B said. I'm just saying. Thank you, y'all. I appreciate y'all for the Cash App, y'all. I had 3 Cash Apps. I'm so sorry. Thank you guys so much for that, y'all. I'm glad that I was able to entertain y'all. I really am. Thank y'all. I appreciate it. I ain't want to be mean, and I thank y'all because I just got the notification and I saw it. So my bad. Thank y'all. I just saw a pic of Robert De Niro new baby. He cute. He cute. He don't look old like Dean and Dylan. Well, Michael is only 63, 64, 65, 66. He in his 60s. And Dean and Dylan look like... They look like churn. And we don't talk about people churn up here. Elderly churn, but churn nonetheless. And so you would think I'm not doing this. I'm not doing this. What you think T and Tamara think about Roger? That's a good question. I would love to know what they think about him. That's a real good question. I would love to know what T and Tamara think about him. What's good, Two Geeks and a Nerd Production? That's a good question. I would love to know what Tim Reed think about him. I would love to know what Jack K think about him. Yeah, I want to know. I want to know. I saw one of them that got crust around his mouth. Other drunk as hell. Other three didn't take their meds. Dean and Dylan are white kids. You know they age fat. I'm not doing it. Look. I'm getting the hell off of here because I ain't got no time. Thank you guys so much for rocking with me with this, you guys. This was a whole lot of fun. Y'all had me up here for 2 hours, up here doing this with y'all, gagging with y'all, and I was only supposed to be up here for, what'd I say, 45 minutes to an hour. This was actually a lot of fun. This was actually a lot of fun. I thoroughly enjoyed doing this, and I think I am going to keep doing this, once a week, just to get y'all a laugh or something like that. Now, what day, I don't know. The day's going to vary. I doubt it's going to be an every Thursday thing, but especially, bitch, I work, okay? So, it may not be that, but I'm definitely going to continue to doing this. We had a nice little crowd, 140 people. I'll accept that because this is a new thing. 163 likes. I'll accept that too. Yeah, too. I'm sorry, friend. I thought you'd been here. Yeah, I've been up here for almost 2 hours, friend. I got to go. The panel is wonderful Monday. Oh, thank you. We have a lot of fun doing the panel, you guys. We do. We have a lot of fun. And it helps because all of us are friends outside of YouTube and outside of the panel. So it definitely works. So definitely, speaking of, the panel is going to be on my house this Monday at 8:30. The panel going to be right here at my house this Monday at 8:30. So definitely make sure that y'all are here. I'm going to make the link for that between now, tomorrow, or whatever. So then that's already out. Make sure that y'all are also here for the live on Saturday for LAMH. And make sure that y'all are also here for Sunday for Roa for that laugh at 10:15. Jesus, LAMH is going to be the death of me. Anyway, that's it. That's all I got. I love you guys. I love on you guys. Again, thank you guys so much for the Cash Apps. Thank you so much for the PayPal love. It was really sweet. Thank you guys so much for wishing me the Happy Nurses Week. It was greatly appreciated. And also thank all of the mama bears that was checking on me when I took sick. Monday morning, child. All of y'all was hitting me up and thinking about me and well wishes, and it is greatly appreciated. What's good, bestie? Shout out to you, friend. Let me go on ahead and end this poll before I end this live, child. y'all got Fantasia beating out Jennifer Hudson, child, 90-10. So yeah, J Hud, not Fantasia. Okay, not Fantasia. All right. Now, if you want to go up against somebody in the verses, I mean, who? I don't know, but not Fan. Not Fan. All right. I maybe I, look, and not even Jasmine Sullivan. Nah, Jasmine Sullivan first album would eat you up alone, J Hud. So no, we can't even do that. The first album would eat you up. I ain't even got on reality show. So not her either. I don't know who J Hud could go up against. You said J Hud and Shantae Moore. I'm dead. Hey, Ray. Oh, there's you, Ray. I'm feeling a lot better. Thank you, boo. Not J Hud and Shantae Moore. We're not even finna do Shantae like that. Because nope. She can't even go up against Shantae. Nope. Nope. She can't even go up against Shantae. Nope. Mm-mm. Nope. Nope. No. No. Listen, at this point, I think the only person she could go up against in a versus battle is Farrah Franklin. Yo, 3LW or somebody. Shit. Luma D. Folk like that, she'll win hands down with folk like that. But yeah, oh yeah, or Melanie Fiona. Oh, see, Yeah, she can't go up against me. She can. She could go up against Medley Fiona. Didn't they come out around the same time? I think that's fair. All right, J Hood, there you go. You and Melanie Fiona. I'm down for that. Now, that's more that I can deal with. Anywho, I'm about to go ahead and go, y'all. Blue Cantrell. Nah, because Blue Cantrell's first album would knock J Hood up out of the water. So I can't even say Blue. If it wasn't for her first album being real damn good, and her second one was good too. Nah, not even Blue. Not even Blue. I don't know. Y'all let me know down in the comments. Somebody said Vivian Green. Now that's a contender. That's a contender. Vivian Green, no shade. But that is a contender. Now I'm with that. Her and Vivian Green, I'll be there for that. Boom, we finally found somebody. Her and Viv. All right. Her and Viv. There you go, J Hood. Hit up Vivian. She ain't doing shit. She'll do it. Anywho, that's it. That's all I got, y'all. And until next time, I'm gone. That. I might be gone. I'm possibly gone. In a few seconds, I'm gonna be gone. All right, I'm gone, Gert.